Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my longer Dreamweaver course that's available on bringyourownlaptop.com. But don't worry, there's lots of free stuff here. Check out the description for the exercise file so you can play along with this tutorial. Also in the description, there'll be a link to the playlist that will show you all the stuff that is free as part of this course. All right, let's get on to the tutorial. Hi there, in this video we're going to look at adding some JavaScript to take this ugly looking desktop menu, and when it switches to mobile, it then when you click the mobile, it shows you the ugly desktop version. Okay, this little toggle click on and off. I realize the styling's not great and there's a few little problems with layout. We'll do that in the video after this one. What you really need to do is pay attention to the magic clicking showing thing we're going to do in JavaScript. So let's go and do that now. First thing before we get on and start making it is, what is JavaScript? Think of, there's three components to a website. There's HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. HTML is an easy one. Think of it as the noun. So it is the things that appear on the page. It's the objects, okay? It's this button here, it's this image, it's this text. Those are all in my HTML and those are things. Then you've got your CSS, and this CSS just describes the styling of things. It says, this is my background color, this is how much padding it's got, it's the pretty stuff, it's the adjective. Okay, so I consider them, HTML as nouns, CSS as adjectives, the describing words, and then you've got the verb, which is JavaScript. What happens when the user clicks this? Okay, so it's the doing of things. It might be that the user clicks a button, like in our case here, this menu drops down, or maybe when a user clicks the play button on a video, or drags a slider, or realigns things on a page. So it's generally the user interacting somehow with your website, JavaScript happens. And when I say we're going to be learning JavaScript, we're actually going to be using something called jQuery. JavaScript is a lot more complicated. So what some clever people did is they created this thing called jQuery. And what it does is it's a library built on top of JavaScript to make it easy for people like us. Instead of having to write lots and lots of syntax out, we can use lots of simple language that makes sense better for humans. And it does pretty much everything we need to do in terms of front-end web design. So we're not learning essential JavaScript, okay? We're learning something called jQuery, which is just easier language used on top of JavaScript. So let's go and do that now. Okay, this little snippet here is gonna help explain what we're doing. I wasn't sure if I should leave it in the tutorial series or not. I'm gonna leave it in probably, just to hopefully explain, instead of just following me blindly, we're gonna figure out what we're doing here. And basically what we're doing is, I'm previewing this in Chrome, and I've just got some nerdy stuff up here to help show you. So basically, what I would like to do is this little navigation here, when the user clicks it on their cell phone, okay, I would like to use JavaScript, okay, so when the user does something, I like the JavaScript to add a class to this little stripy menu called expand, okay, and that'll expand the menu out. Because at the moment, there it is there, desktop menu, it's got one class applied called desktop menu, no other classes. What I'd like to say is, when it's clicked, to magically use JavaScript to inject a class into here to make it expand. So watch this. Keep an eye on this thing here. When I click it, I'm a user using my mobile phone. I click it and magically this extra class there, go away, that gets added. And that little class there we're going to define in our CSS to say, make it nice and big and show us the menu there. So that's what we need the JavaScript to do. Okay, so let's go learn how to do that using JavaScript and jQuery. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna create that expand class. Okay, so we're gonna put it in our styles.css, we're gonna put it in global, and we're gonna say in our selectors, we're gonna create it, it's called dot. Okay, remember it's a class we're making up. Okay, it's gonna be called expand. And what we would like this thing to do is display. Okay, and we're gonna say display block. Your little job as a class is, when you're applied to anything, is to show things up. But what we're gonna do is get that to apply with JavaScript, not hard code it like we have for everything else. So the next thing we need to do is create our JavaScript file and connect it to our index page. Now, when we did it with our styles.css, it happened automatically because we've got this cool little CSS designer panel. To do it with JavaScript, we do it a little bit the long way. Let's go to File, New, and let's go to New Document. Let's click JavaScript and let's click Create. It's called Untitled, let's save it. Where are we gonna save it? We'll put it inside of our desktop, inside my files here called Dan's Awesome Portfolio. I could save it in with the rest of the files, but it's really common to create a folder called JS. Inside of that folder, okay, I'm gonna put in this file called, it's really common to call it scripts. You can call it anything you like. Okay, but most people call it scripts.js. Let's click save. Now let's go and close it down. And so we just made it, we close it down, because now we need to link it to this index.html file. And you can set up here, I'm in index and in source code. And you can see here, remember the styles.css? This was done automatically for us. We need to do this manually. So we need to put a return in, and we need to go to insert, and we need to go down to scripts. Okay, go on scripts again. And it knows it's going to the JS file, find scripts, click open, and there you go. There's a link together. Hit save, and you can see there's my styles.css, and now my new little scripts file. This burger menu up here is because it's an SVG. If you use the PNG version of our little menu before, this won't appear there. Okay, just ignore him for the rest of the course. So go to scripts.js, and now we get to add the JavaScript, or in our case, jQuery, that controls that turning on and off. Okay, I totally lied. We're not ready to write JavaScript yet. What happens is your computer, or at least the browser that people watch your website on, will understand JavaScript just fine, but it'll get to the jQuery, which is basically shorthand for JavaScript, and go, the hang are you talking about? This is not JavaScript. So what we need to do in our source code is we need to, at the top here, tell it where to look for the definitions of jQuery. And you do it using something called a CDN, or a content delivery network. There's a few of them online. Okay, and so we're going to go to Google, and we're going to type in jQuery CDN, and there's a bunch of places you can link to. So you can go to jquery.com. I use the Google one. Where is he? Down here. Where's Google? developers.google.com. And here it says, this is the little link for jQuery. I'm going to grab it all, snippet. Okay, actually starts up there. Grab all of that chunk. What I've done for you is I've put it in your exercise files under code. There's something called jQuery CDN. You don't have to come here, you can just copy and paste my one. So I'm gonna copy it, and all we do is dump it in here, okay, and that just tells it where the library is. Why do we just not have it locally? Like we've got scripts.js in our CSS on my machine. The reason is because this is a really big library. And the benefit of using, say, the one hosted by Google, it means that, say, a user is surfing the net and they go to 10 sites, okay, that all use jQuery because loads of sites use it. When they get to your site and the browser goes, oh, I'm gonna have to load jQuery, and it goes, don't worry about it. I won't load it because I've already loaded it from this other website that I was at last. That's why we use a CDN, like, and link to a website rather than having it actually on your machine. Okay, it just means that Google's gonna have it online all the time, loads of people use it, and that, yeah, you don't have to download it like a millionth time when they get to your site, because it's just that same old one that's been linking to there again. So the browser of the user doesn't bother going and learning all this new language again. It's already there, it already knows it. Long story short, just copy and paste that, stick it in the top, and it will help. Let's go to scripts.js, and in here, we're gonna learn a little bit of jQuery. And just so you know, when you are designing websites, 9 times out of 10, you're gonna be using jQuery rather than pure JavaScript. So the first thing we need to do is tell it we're using jQuery. You can see the little coding hint helping there. Okay, and what we're gonna say is we're gonna put in lots of brackets and lots of curly braces. So let's get ready for them. First bit is we're gonna put in our brackets. Inside this bracket, we're gonna write the word document. Thank you, code helping. After the brackets, we're gonna type in ready. All this just means is that jQuery don't load until the document's ready. Because what can happen is jQuery can start doing its thing before the document is even loaded or the whole page is loaded, and it just causes lots of errors. So what we just say is wait for the document to load and then do your thing, and you'll find you don't get any errors. Cool, the next thing we need to do is tell it to do something. So in brackets, we say do something please. Okay, but we don't call it do something please, we call it a function. Just think, oh, I'd like you to do something, but code language is called a function. And now we put in a set of brackets, set of curly braces, and at the end we put in a semicolon. So these things here, I never really do anything with these first set of brackets. Okay, these are attributes that normally are just left empty. Okay, these curly braces are the really important parts. Okay, we're gonna put all the things we want to do inside of this. And this last little semicolon just means finished here. I'm done. I've finished writing my jQuery, don't go on any further. So all of the good stuff goes inside these curly braces. I could type them out here, okay, but it's gonna look a little messy. So I'm gonna undo, and what we'll do is just put a return in between. Okay, and we'll just type them in here. Now I want to say again, I'd like to say I'm using jQuery. Okay, but instead of saying that, jQuery is a long word, and what the shorthand is dollar sign. Okay, so dollar sign, just think, is the shorthand for the word jQuery. So we're gonna replace this one up here, because you'd be weird if you were using the word jQuery. Everyone uses dollar signs. So we're saying jQuery, I would like to do something. Okay, and in this case, we're going to use brackets again. Inside of this brackets, I would like to add apostrophes, not quotes, apostrophes. Because what I'd like to do is I'd like to do something with the class, remember period for class, something with the mobile view. Okay, what would we like to do with them? I'd like to look out for a click. So when you're clicked, I'd like you to brackets do something. And remember, we don't use the word do something, we use the word function. Same bit of crazy syntax. Brackets with nothing in it. Semicolons where the good stuff goes. And at the end, we put in a semicolon to say, don't go on past here, please. So in where the good stuff goes, put a return. Same as above, dollar sign for jQuery. Same thing with a class. Okay, we're going to put in apostrophes, a dot, desktop view. What would we like to do to this desktop view? I'd like to add this thing. Instead of a click, this one's going to have a toggle class. Okay, and that toggle class is going to toggle this thing called apostrophe expand. Remember that class we made earlier? Weirdly, we don't write in the full stop for this particular one. Just leave it off, okay? Otherwise it doesn't work. Okay, get to the end here and say, don't read anymore. And that is gonna hopefully make our menu work. So let's backdate it. We're gonna say there's an expand class that I have. I'd like to toggle it on and off desktop view when mobile view is clicked. If that was a mind bender and there's commas and apostrophes flying all over the place, I've created a code you can copy and paste in your exercise files. You can go download those, they're free. So that is writing some jQuery. Let's go see if it works is the main thing. Remember, save all, jump into our browser, shrink it down, click the button, and it doesn't work. Okay, I have to pause this to figure out why it's not working. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back and I figured it out. Happens to the best of us. I really want to re-record the video and make me look super awesome, but I also want to let you know that it always happens. Happens to everybody. Okay, and what I did was under styles.css, it's actually working. I tested it and the expand class is getting added. So it's nothing wrong with the jQuery, it's the styles.css. What's happening, I put this in, I wanted to expand in desktop, but I actually need this thing because it's in global. I need this to be in tablet and in mobile view. So I'm going to grab this. You're in the wrong place. Cut them. And I want you to be in. You can see my media query here. This is for my max min for tablet. So just before the ending of the close bracket. See, there's the opening. And there's the closing there. I'm going to put them in. So I need a copy in there. And down in mobile view, I need a copy in there. All right. Whoops. Now let's go and test. All right, now click on it. Still not working, hit refresh. Now it's working. Click, click, our jQuery works. It still looks ugly, I know, and there's some layout to be done, but we'll turn that into another video because this one, dang, could be the longest video I've made in my video career history. Okay, so yeah, that is our jQuery clicky mobile and desktop drop-down menu-y thing. Now let's make this menu look kind of nice. Hey, if you enjoyed this video, please like it and consider subscribing to my channel. Also, go to Bring Your Own Laptop for the full premium version of this course. Also, on that website is a free resources section where you can download PDFs, especially for this, the Dreamweaver cheat sheet. Okay, it's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer, and be more awesome. Bye now.